Hey everybody, it's Goody Parade, and today I am going to open my Peri and Pearl two-headed anti-styling head. Although I don't think this is an anti-styling head at all. I think it's totally styling. It's just monster styling. The box is so fantastic and big, colorful, and amazing and super pretty. It says 30 plus pieces, temporary decals, Spook Out Peri and Pearl with glow accessories, jewels and gems. I found this at Walmart. So up at the top are these cool tentacles. And then the top of the box is coffin-ish shaped with a nice window so you can see inside and some really pretty cool art. Just love it. And there's like the underwater village there. Display jewelry and gems. Oh, I guess in the tail. Glow accessories. 30 plus pieces, customized temporary decals. And then look at that. I know once I remove this from the box, I can never go back. And I'm gonna open it. Wow, so cute. Love it. And the back of the box is all beautiful, ocean, bubbly, sunlight, watery. Peri and Pearl are out. They are so fabulous. I love them. Here's their tail. They also came with some instructions, a little bag of temporary tattoos that we can do in a minute. And let's just go ahead and dump that out. So these look like earrings or their tail. Their tail. See, the tail has holes to display stuff, and it's got a little notch here to snap it on the back. I think that's our next step. Fair enough, there's a little hole there, and I'm gonna take that, and hopefully that's gonna snap right in. Not. Okay, I think it's there. All right, let's get back to the front. Are they just gorgeous? She's got a spider barrette, and she's got coral with jewelry on it. Look at the details. She's got scales here. Her fingers are webbed. She's got this beautiful fin and this really cool texture, and she's articulated at the wrist and the elbow. This toy does not disappoint. I am so excited. Oh my gosh, this jewelry is just awesome. So there's some empty spots here where I think we could put some of these little things that came with it in. And this cool belt and the fin on the side. Same hand over there. And also I love their noses have these little, you can see they're like little scales. The chest, awesome. What does she have? An earring over here. Let's look at the jewelry. It's a little anchor, little hanging chandelier, monster high keys, cool little shark's tooth. And these little tiny, whoa, thingies. These thingies, which I think go in the necklace. In fact, let's just do that now. That's cute. I like that. That's really, really cute. Oh my gosh, I love her. Okay, let's look at the tattoos to choose from. I've done a styling head where it just was vinyl that pulled on and off easily, and this you actually have to get it wet, just like you're putting a temporary tattoo on yourself. So there's those amazing eyes. Those are amazing. Oh, neat, just lines. Neat. textures. Wow, that's kind of cray-cray. Okay, I like some of that stuff. Maybe we'll do some of that stuff. Also, she did come with this. That is so cool. Let's check out her hair. So pretty. It was really soft. It's super silky. It just goes right through those little teeth. Schwack, silky. Oh, there's the other little shark's tooth. It's on the back of the tail there. Cute. Pretty, pretty hair. Oh, I like the cut. It's got a lot, a long layer to it. Oh, combs so nicely. Look at her. Sassy. That is some nice combing hair. I also like that it's really sturdy. It doesn't feel like it's going to tip over on me. And when you have a two-headed styling head, you could see how it could become top-heavy with two heads of hair. Okay, now that I have the tail on, now I really want to take the tail off because it's in the way of me doing her beautiful hair. But maybe if I braid their hair together, that will all change, right? Well, I'm not sure that turned out as great as I had hoped. But that's okay. Oh, I kind of like their little hangy downies. I wish there were more barrettes, more than two. All right, let's see. What can we do here? I'm gonna do these big blue, I don't know, eyeshadow. It's kind of tacky to the touch. This paper feels pretty thick though, and it says only get your finger wet, so it's hard to imagine it doesn't need that much water, but okay, so that's gonna go on her. Does she just have to kind of figure out where and hope for the best, I guess? My finger wet, which we'll see. Okay, I'm gonna really rub. Okay, let's see. Half of it came off. Ooh, it's pretty blue though. How pretty is that? That would have been really pretty if it came out all the way. I don't know. I'm not crazy about this. Another thing that's different about this head is what they have on their eyes is on them. It's painted on permanently. And you can't take it off. Like this anti-styling head I had didn't even have eyes. When you peeled the eyes off, it was just white, which I thought was cool. But since this is actually a character, Peri and Pearl, I guess they want them to actually be Peri and Pearl. And then you can put the tattoos around on their skin if you want. Personally, I'm not really into that. I do love the hair. I could see doing some really wild hair, like, you know, sticking out all over the place and some twists and some rolls, definitely. But yeah, double hair. Imagine like double beehive, big bouffants. Let's see if this belt comes off. I think it does. Oh, I think it does, but it like pushes in this little hole. Like a peg, two pegs that pop in there, and I am not gonna undo that. You can try that. The necklace, I believe the necklace is one that it could just pull off. Oh my gosh, I love this necklace. Two necks. That is darling. Oh my gosh. I'm not crazy about the tattoo thing. I like the head just as it is, but overall, one of the coolest toys ever. She's just gonna go down in toy history in my book. Super rad, super awesome. Oh, here's her tail. If you wanna put some things. I'll work on their hair a little bit more and then we'll do some glow in the dark. All right, I've played with her for a while
And I did her hair and I played with the tattoos and I'll show you guys what I came up with. I'm still just so in love with this toy. It's just so adorable. I mean, a two-headed styling head. Okay. So one thing I did do was I added some of my own jewelry. I think they need some real gold for that scarier reef thing. I thought they could use some real jewels. And I also put some gold earrings on their plastic neon ones because I thought they needed some hoops. They've got that kind of seafaring pirate vibe going on. I thought that was cool. I also painted their nails with real nail polish, just a little bit of red. And I did get the hang of the tattoos, which I got a damp washcloth and just patted it on the back of the papers. I cut them out real small, put them on, patted them on, and tapped them, and I kind of got the hang of it. It just took a long time to cut them all out and put them on, but I really liked it actually because I feel like it's on there really good. Like this is whole one piece of tattoo, this cool scaly texture. And over here, it kind of goes from a green to a pink. I really like that. We've got stars on our hand, or their hand, I'm not sure. And I did some just fun designs on their face. I didn't go too crazy because I think they're just beautiful the way they are. And I also wanted to show you the tattoo thing. Once you get it on, and if you want it off, all you have to do is scratch it. Literally scratches right off. It's like a lottery ticket scratcher, if you know what those are. And see, just comes right off. So it's a little messy, makes some crumbs, but nothing mage. I thought that was pretty cool. I like that. And then let's see their hair. I did a big barrel curl here. It kind of reminds me of operetta, kind of that vintage style. And then she's got her barrette in the back. She's got a neon earring here and then my gold earring. And then I French braided their hair together and then braided it when it came together here. And I like that because you could actually see their neck and there's a few things that you couldn't totally see. I love these black ruffles on their shoulders here. So her hair, I just kept kind of simple. I did put this barrette in and I tried to kind of prop it up so it almost looks like a little tiara. And that's it. I kind of braided it together. I twined it and I'm not so happy with the look of that. This tail really honestly was a pain in the butt because it's in the way. When her hair is down, it's right here and the hair goes over it and under it and all around it. Then I wanted to snap it off, but I remembered how hard it was to get it on, so I didn't. So then I did take these in the dark to check the glowing powers, and I tried to videotape it, but it wouldn't even show up on camera. It was that weak. And pretty much the only thing that glows are these things. And personally, I'm not even that crazy about these because I like to bejewel them with real gold. And in fact, I think I'm going to put some pearls in the holes in her tail. And I just want to say again how much I love that she's articulated. I love that her wrists are articulated and her elbows and arms, because most styling dolls either have no arms or they're stuck in some weird paint my nails position or something. So I love that. So yeah, again, there's these holes where you can put these plastic glow in the dark things that kind of barely glow, and I don't know, I just didn't like them. Oh, I tried some twine in here just to kind of decorate it. I don't think it was that successful, but I think I'm going to just hook some real jewelry. Put my earrings in there. I could put a bracelet over here, a ring, and it could be a cute place to display and store real jewelry. All right, guys. Well, I just love her. I can't wait to hear if you guys love her and if you have them or her or it or them. I'm not sure. What did you guys do to yours? Well, that's it. Let me know what you think and be sure to subscribe for future videos. Thanks so much for watching and bye for now.